Learn English with podcast conversation.
All right, so we're diving into something a lot of you have been asking about. That whole village versus city living thing.
Oh, yeah, that's a classic.
Right, like where's the best place to be? And you know what? We stumbled on this this English learning video.
Oh, wow.
On YouTube, of all places.
Yeah.
That actually tackles this very question.
Interesting.
Yeah. Who knew an English lesson could, like, spark such a deep dive?
Right. Well, you never know where inspiration's going to come from.
Exactly.
No.
And what's really cool about this video is it's not just like random people talking.
Right.
It features two people who've actually lived in both a village and the city.
So they've got firsthand experience.
They've walked the walk.
Yeah.
So their insights are super valuable.
That makes their opinions so much more, I don't know, like, grounded.
Grounded, yeah, exactly. So they start off talking about the village, right? And they hit on all those classic charms. Peace and quiet, beautiful nature, that friendly, you know, close-knit community vibe. One of them even says that in villages, people have closer relationships with their neighbors and they tend to support each other.
And that's something that you don't always get in the city.
Right.
Like that real sense of community.
Yeah, it taps into that human need for belonging.
Definitely.
To feel safe, supported.
Like you're part of something.
Exactly.
Bigger than yourself.
Yeah, but here's where it gets interesting.
Okay.
The video doesn't shy away from the downsides of village life either.
Oh, interesting.
They bring up the fact that facilities are not as advanced.
Ooh, that's a big one.
That's a pretty big caveat.
Yeah, because it's not just about missing out on, you know, fancy restaurants or whatever.
Right.
It can be things like healthcare.
Access to jobs.
Good schools for your kids.
Reliable internet, even.
Oh, for sure. Especially nowadays.
Yeah, so it's not all roses and quaint cottages, right?
Yeah.
There are some real practical things to consider.
Absolutely.
Okay, so let's flip the script and head to the city.
All right, the concrete jungle.
Exactly. The video lays out all the classic city perks. More job opportunities, better education, endless entertainment, that constant buzz of activity.
You always feel like something's going on.
Right.
Yeah, it's like the city itself is this energy source.
Pushing you to grow and do more.
Almost like you can be anyone you want.
And let's be honest, there's also that fear of missing out, right?
The FOMO, yeah.
If you're not in the city, are you really experiencing life to the fullest?
Some people definitely feel that way.
But of course, the video keeps it real. Cool. They talk about the city downsides, too. The crowds, the noise, the pollution, that feeling of just being constantly overwhelmed.
Yeah, it's definitely a sensory overload.
Like, I think anyone who's ever been stuck in rush hour traffic can relate to that.
Oh, absolutely.
So we've got this tension, right?
Yeah, the allure and the reality.
On both village and city life.
It's like a push and pull.
And the key takeaway from the video is this.
Okay.
Both speakers agree there's no one-size-fits-all answer.
That makes sense.
It boils down to, and I'm quoting here,
okay,
personal preferences and lifestyle.
Right, because what works for one person might be a nightmare for someone else.
Absolutely.
It's about figuring out what really matters to you.
What are your priorities?
What are you willing to compromise on?
Are you looking for peace and quiet or excitement and opportunity?
Big question.
Big question, but good ones. Right.
Definitely good ones.
So that's where we're going to pick up in the next part of this deep dive.
I'm excited to see where we go.
Me too. We're going to shift the focus to you, the listener.
Oh, I like that.
And help you figure out your own personal village city equation.
Perfect.
So stay tuned for that.
Can't wait. So before we, you know, jump into your personal equation, it's worth pointing out, like, how the speakers in this video, they really bring the whole village versus city debate to life, you know?
Oh, yeah, totally. They use such vivid examples.
Right. It's not just abstract concepts.
Like peace versus opportunity.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like real life scenarios. Exactly. And that makes you think, huh, have I ever felt that way?
For example, when they're talking about village life.
Yeah.
One speaker mentions how people are more likely to help each other out in times of need.
And they get specific, right?
Oh, totally.
Like imagine your car breaks down on some deserted road.
Oh, yeah. In the middle of nowhere.
And in a village, someone's more likely to stop and help.
Or even invite you in for tea while you wait for a tow truck.
It's like that classic image of, you know, small town hospitality.
It's so charming. Right?
It is. But then it makes you wonder, like, would that happen in a big city?
Right. Would anyone even notice you?
Let alone stop and offer a hand.
It's like, is there a trade-off? You get anonymity in the city, maybe more freedom.
True. True.
But you might also lose that sense of connection.
Like real human connection, not just, you know, online friends.
Exactly.
Do you actually know your neighbors?
That's a good point. Now, on the flip side, when they're talking about city life, one of the big advantages they highlight is exposure to different cultures.
Oh, that's a big one for me.
Right. And they don't just mean like trying different foods.
Or listening to world music.
Yeah, yeah. It's deeper than that.
It's about encountering different perspectives, you know?
On a daily basis.
Yeah, like challenging your assumptions.
Broadening your worldview.
Making you confront your own biases.
Yeah, I had never thought about it that way.
It's powerful.
But yeah, it's so true. Like living in a city is like having a front row seat to like...
the human experience.
In all its messy glory.
Yeah, all the different ways people live and think and believe.
Exactly.
And that can be uncomfortable sometimes.
Oh, for sure.
But it's also where real growth happens.
It's like a constant crash course in empathy, right?
Yeah, you're constantly learning, adapting.
You brought up growth, and I feel like that's like...
a common thread.
Yeah, this whole village versus city thing.
It's like it's not just about where we live.
It's about how we want to live, right?
How we want to evolve as people.
But how do we make that happen while dealing with real life, you know?
Well, that's where this idea of, like, curating experiences comes in.
Okay, explain that.
Like, maybe it's not about choosing one or the other.
Village or city.
Yeah, but about intentionally seeking out elements of both.
Regardless of where you actually live?
Exactly.
So, like, how would someone living in a busy city, how would they create those village moments?
Well, they could join a community garden.
Oh, that's nice.
Connect with their neighbors, grow some food.
It's like building those small-scale connections.
Well, maybe volunteering at a local soup kitchen, something like that.
Get back to the community.
And meet people who share your values.
Yeah, I love that. But what about those of us who, like, crave a bit of city buzz?
But live in a quieter place.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, technology can actually help with that.
Really?
You can join online communities.
Oh, that makes sense.
Based on your interests, you know?
Okay.
Take online courses, learn new things.
Keep your mind stimulated.
Or even plan regular trips to a nearby city.
Oh, yeah, just to get a dose of that energy.
It's about being proactive, right?
And saying, okay, this is missing, so how can I create it?
Exactly. You have more control than you think.
I like that. You know, it's interesting. The speakers in the video, they never actually say, this is the answer, village or city.
No, they don't.
They keep coming back to individual preferences.
Yeah.
Finding what feels right for you.
Which makes sense because everyone's different.
It's like there's no right or wrong.
As long as you're being true to yourself.
And maybe, just maybe, this whole debate, it's not about finding the best place to live, but about recognizing that both village and city life, they have their own unique
advantages and disadvantages.
Exactly. And the ideal choice, it depends on so many factors.
Your values, your needs, your circumstances.
And maybe it's also about finding ways to like...
mitigate the downside?
Yeah, yeah. Can we design cities that feel more connected?
That's a good question.
Even though they're so busy and crowded.
And can we preserve the peace of rural areas while still making sure people have access to, you know...
opportunities, resources. So it's not village or city. It's like, how can both ways of life thrive?
How can we create a world where people can choose the environment that's best for them?
And what's really hitting me is this idea that it's not just about physical spaces.
No.
It's about cultivating a mindset.
Like an internal balance.
Yes. Like you can live in a city and still create those village moments.
The close friendships, those supportive networks.
And you can live in a village and still cultivate that. Like
the city energy.
Yeah. That openness to new experiences, that drive to learn and grow.
It's about finding that equilibrium, you know?
Yeah.
Between belonging and exploration.
And that's a lifelong journey, right?
It is. It's a constant dance.
So we started with this English learning video.
Yeah.
And now we're talking about
human nature.
I know. Societal evolution, what makes a fulfilling life?
It's amazing where these deep dives can take us.
It really is. So we're going to wrap up this part here.
Okay.
But in the next part, we're going to dive even deeper.
Oh, exciting.
We're going to explore some of the broader implications of this whole village versus city debate.
I can't wait.
So stay tuned for that.
Okay, so we're back and ready for the final part of our village-city deep dive.
I feel like we've uncovered so much already.
I know, right? Like from those personal pros and cons to that whole idea of curating experiences.
Blending the best of both worlds.
But it's crazy how this simple question of where should I live like touches on such deeper stuff.
It's like we're peeling back layers of history.
And psychology.
It really makes you think about human nature.
It gives me chills, like this whole village-city tension that's been going on for like all of human history.
Like a fundamental dilemma.
Woven into our DNA.
I like that. Woven into our DNA.
Like on one hand, we crave that village vibe.
Yeah.
Security, belonging, knowing your
Your feeling
neighbors.
of being rooted, right?
Yeah, like you're part of something solid.
But then there's this other side of us
The explorer, the adventurer.
who wants to push boundaries, see new things.
Expand our horizons.
It's like we're wired for both comfort and excitement.
That duality is fascinating.
And it shaped everything. Like, think about it.
What do you mean?
The rise of cities, that was huge EE for humanity.
Oh, absolutely.
It allowed for like specialization of labor.
People could focus on specific skills.
Exactly. And that fueled trade, innovation.
It led to the complex societies we have today.
But like with any big change,
There are always downsides.
right? Cities brought their own set of problems.
Overcrowding, competition.
Social divisions, a sense of anonymity
It's like we traded the intimacy of the village
for the opportunities of the city.
and had to deal with a whole new set of challenges.
So maybe this debate isn't about better or worse,
No.
but about recognizing the trade-off.
That each way of life comes with
Like village life might offer,
connection support,
but it might also mean
limited opportunities, isolation even.
and city life might bring
Excitement, diversity,
you're also
stress, anonymity.
It's complex.
It really is.
And the ideal choice,
Depends on the individual.
their values, needs,
You
circumstances.
can't just give a blanket answer.
And maybe it's also about, like you said before.
Mitigating the downside.
Yeah. Can we design cities that feel more,
Human.
more connected, even though they're so big?
Urban planners are working on that, you know?
Thinking about green spaces, community hubs.
Designing for interaction, not just efficiency.
And on the flip side, how can we preserve the beauty of rural areas while still giving people
Access to services, opportunities,
it's finding that
but
balance.
sustainable balance.
So it's not village or city.
No.
It's like both andy.
Creating a world where both ways of life can flourish.
And what's really sticking with me
Going.
is this idea that it's not just external,
About physical places.
right? It's also internal.
Like a mindset.
Yes, you can live in a city but still cultivate that village spirit.
Close relationships, rituals, traditions.
And you can live in a village but have that city mindset.
Open to new ideas, always learning.
It's about finding that balance within yourself.
A dynamic
I
equilibrium
love that dynamic equilibrium.
between belonging and exploring.
It's a lifelong journey, isn't it?
It is a constant dance.
Wow, we've covered so much
We really have
from an English learning video.
to like the meaning of life.
I know. It's amazing how these deep dives unfold.
It's the beauty of exploration.
So, listener, we leave you with this.
Okay.
What does this whole village city thing reveal about you?
About your values, your
Yeah.
priorities
How do you navigate that balance
between connection and exploration?
in your own life?
It's a question worth pondering.
Keep diving deep, keep
And
exploring,
keep those conversations going.
because ultimately it's about finding what works for you.
Your own unique path.
That's it for this deep dive. Thanks for joining us.
It's been a pleasure.